Hey guys, welcome back to Magic TV. My name's Craig. It is 9 o'clock on a Monday. It's time for a 5x5. This is where I take five subjects related to magic. I spend 5 minutes talking about each subject. I move on to the next subject. It's quick, it's snappy. You never know what you're going to get. And today I'm doing another performer spotlight special where I actually take a closer look at a magician and show you some performance videos of them performing and talk about what we can learn from their performances. And today I'm going to talk to you about one of my favourite magicians of all time, Russ Stevens. Now, anybody that's been watching this channel for any length of time will know that I have mad respect for Russ Stevens. The guy has literally changed the game and then some. First of all, when I was a kid, I grew up watching Mystique of Blackpool, which is his illusion show. That's what made me want to go into performing on stage. He was a massive inspiration to me back in the day. Then with his company RSVP Magic, he literally changed the game when it came to instructional content for magicians. His tricks that he put out, his projects that he put out, formed the basis of the majority of the material that I used in my early days as a close-up magician. The production quality was way ahead of its time. The teaching, the actual content, you know, when RSVP was churning out content all of the time, you know, you wanted to be one of those people that was represented by RSVP because it was almost like a badge of honor. And then, you know, him along with Guy Barrett and Russ Brown have rejuvenated the Blackpool Magic Convention and made it what it is now, where every single year it gets bigger and bigger and bigger. And then obviously that's not even talking about what he does on Britain's Got Talent. And I have experienced this firsthand with him working with Ryland when Ryland did Britain's Got Talent. I can tell you right now that Russ has an innate ability that I haven't seen anyone else exhibit that allows him to take any act and just make it better. By tweaking things and adding certain moments and music. And he's just got this ability to take something good and make it great and take something great and make it unbeatable. I have a lot of respect for Russ Stevens, but you know what? Above and beyond all of that, I haven't even talked about Russ Stevens, the performer. And that's what I'm going to talk about on this video. I'm going to talk about Russ, the performer, because Russ Stevens is one of the best performers in the world, as far as I'm concerned. He made illusions cool. I remember when I first saw Mystique, I liked illusions, but it wasn't something that I really wanted to do. And it was watching him perform on stage and watching how he did everything that made me just want to be that person up on stage. You know, he's an inspiration to so many people. And I'm going to break down five of his routines. Now, you're going to hear me say the same thing in a lot of these videos. And the reason is something that Russ does that nobody else seems to be able to do as well as him is he understands about the staging. A lot of magicians, especially magicians that perform on stage, they think about the magic because they think that's the most important thing, right? It's all about the magic. And obviously the magic's important. But one thing that I learned from Russ is the magic is only one element towards a successful show. There's a lot of other things that you need to think about as well. You need to think about the staging. You need to think about the lighting. You need to think about cameras. If you're on TV, where are the camera angles? What's going to play better for this audience or this camera? You think about the music. Russ's choice of music is impeccable. If you watch some of the acts he's involved in Britain's Got Talent, if you watch some of his own acts, the music just heightens and takes the performance to an entire other level. And you see that over and over again. So you're going to hear me talking about a few different things to do with that. And really, if I'm talking about musicality, I think that the first thing that we have to look at is the routine that really, I don't want to say put Russ on the map because he was already on the map when this took place, but it's a perfect example of doing something which nobody else had done and just really a perfect example of his ability to stage and routine and act. This is Russ's Shape of My Heart routine. So from 16 or 17 years ago. Now let's have a look at this first of all, and then we'll talk about it.
For the last 7 years, my next guest has been returning by popular demand to Blackpool for an amazing 7-month season with his fabulous show, Mystique. Please welcome the superb Russ Stevens.
Yeah. for cards as a meditation. Those he plays never suspect. He doesn't play for the money he wins. He doesn't play for respect. He deals the cards to find the answer. Sacred geometry of chance, the hidden law of a probable outcome, the numbers lead a dance. I know that the spades are the swords of a soldier. I know that the clubs are weapons of war. I know that diamonds this art, but that's not the shape of my heart. He may play the jack of diamonds, he may lay the queen of spades, he may conceal a king in his hand while a memory of it fades. Spades are the swords of a soldier. I know that the clubs are weapons of war. I know that diamonds mean money for this art, but that's not the shape of my heart. That's not the shape.
So that is Russ's Shape of My Heart routine, and it's one of the finest pieces of card manipulation I've ever seen. And it's the thing that made Ryland want to learn to be a card manipulator. It was watching Russ do that that just kind of popped his eyes open. Because the problem is, you see a lot of card manipulators, and it's just too much to follow. It's just like everything's going on at the same time. Well, what Russ was very successful at doing was slowing everything down and making it so that every moment hit and hit hard. And obviously he used Sting's Shape of My Heart routine. This is an Shape of My Heart music track. And this is an iconic routine for Russ. This is, you know, a routine that has become synonymous with him. Up until that point, nobody had used Shape of My Heart. Like, nobody had used Shape of My Heart. And do you want to know how he was able to do this and how he was able to be the first person to be able to innovate this particular sequence? The reason is very simple. And having got to know Russ, I know this. I see it firsthand. He spends hours listening to music. He'll just listen to music on Spotify. And I've spoken to him on the phone and I've rung him up, or he's rung me up, and he said, hey, I've got this wonderful piece of music that I've just heard. For him, you know, like some people, when they create magic, they're looking for that piece of inspiration. They're looking for that thing and, you know, that trick that will make them famous. Russ thinks that way about music. He really does. So it doesn't surprise me that the person who was able to put this wonderful sequence together with Sting's iconic track is Russ Stevens, because that's what he does and what he's continued to do through his whole career. And if you plan on performing on stage, if you plan on being a stage magician, I encourage you to sit down and watch this over and over again, because it is so inspirational. It really is how he can just sit there on a stool and do this magic, which is beautiful magic anyway, but then do it and have the music and listen to the music and look at the productions that are taking place at that time. It literally is poetry in motion. And it's a perfect example of why I consider Russ a genius. I really do consider him a genius. These 5x5s are my love letter to performers that I love. You know, you've seen me do them with people like Scott Alexander, Bill Malone, David Regal. These are all my favorite magicians, and Russ is one of my favorite magicians of all time. And I encourage anybody who wants to perform on stage to watch this, just like I've got Ryland to watch this over and over again. It's fantastic. And a perfect example of understanding the use of musicality. So next up, we're going to go in a completely different direction, and we're going to go and have a look at a routine that Russ did when he was doing a TV spot with Anton Deck. Now, he's using the cube zag here, and I'm not going to say any more on it. I'm going to let you see the performance, and then we're going to talk about it.
Top illusionist, Russ Stevens! How are you, mate?
Great. Fine, thanks.
You're going to show us a trick today, aren't you?
Certainly am.
Right.
We need the four aces, OK? So we've got one, two, three, four.
By crikey! Hey! But that's not it, is it?
OK, just name any colour, red or black?
Red.
OK, hold your hand out and watch really closely. Got the ace of diamonds. I put that face down on your hand. The ace of hearts, face down there. Ready? Watch. See anything happen?
No.
Feel anything?
I felt a bit of a shiver.
Watch.
Oh, hey!
Brilliant, that. Cheers.
I tell you, it's good to get a proper bit of showbiz on this show.
Well, you're not so bad yourself.
Thank you. How about we do that big illusion that we talked about later on in the show?
It's a good idea, but what about Deck?
Ah, don't worry about Deck. He'll be okay.
Okay.
Right, so what I thought we could do... Yeah. I've bought you a present, mate.
Oh, and you shouldn't have.
Yeah, it isn't no thing, Deck. It isn't no thing.
You see, Pubkid, all that messing about on camera like we really hate each other and we're always in competition, it's all just a big joke, really.
Mm.
In fact, we're really very, very best friends. And I'd probably go as far as to say I think I love you, Ant.
Aw, oh, Deck, get off. There's no need to see something things out on the show. Teddy, bring the present on. Deck, you're going to love this present.
Am I?
Look at it.
Oh, I...
Big, marvellous present, isn't it?
Oh,
it's a marvellous present. Deck.
It's... What is it?
Isn't it obvious?
No.
Well, it's a trophy cabinet for all the marvellous trophies you keep winning, isn't it?
Of course it is.
You see, but it's a very special trophy cabinet because, Declan...
Yeah?
You've got to get inside and see your trophies, you see.
Is that what
your
you
trophies
do?
Are in there. But if you just get in...
Oh, brilliant.
In, you'll see all your trophies, right? Deck,
so,
can you see them?
No.
No. Well, keep looking, Deck, keep looking. I'm sure they'll be there, Declan. Can you see them?
No.
No?
No.
Isn't that strange? Because now you're into the strange and magnificent world of Ant McPartlin and Russ Stevens. Give it up! I'm rid of Declan Dully forever.
Thank you very much,
Hold
Anthony.
On a second. Here is your payment, £50,000 in cash.
That's great, thank
and
you.
And I'll see you later.
See you later.
Hey!
Thank you.
Now that's magic.
Now, I, through my career, haven't had many opportunities to perform on TV. I've had a few, but not really that many, because it's really not been something that I've been that interested in. But I do know, you know, having spent a lot of time with Ryland, who's been on TV way more than me, and other people, friends of mine that talk about TV all the time, I do know that when you are invited to perform on television and you have that TV spot, it is so important to get the right piece to perform. And there's so many factors and there's so many elements that need to be taken into consideration. A lot of people that watch Britain's Got Talent, they wonder why this was done or that was done. And they don't understand what happens behind the scenes in terms of framing or the amount of time you have and how things get changed round and the fact that you have to maybe do it this way or, you know, this needs to happen or that person needs to be involved. And I think the reason I included this performance in this particular video is because it shows how you can take a very short TV spot, I think this is 4 minutes long, and you can actually use it to really further your brand as a magician or an illusionist. Because anybody who's watched this, you know, back in 1992 or whenever it was, anybody who watched Russ do this on stage on that TV show at the time will go away thinking, oh my God, Russ Stevens is the best magician ever, because he did a little bit of everything. First of all, he did a little close-up trick. Then he got Ant involved in the illusion. You can see that. And having that person, that host or that celebrity be involved in the illusion is just a really super smart idea. I know some people watching this are going to go, well, the Cube Zag, you know, that's been around forever. It's like doing an ambitious card on stage, on TV. But it absolutely 100% works so well. And it looks great, and the music was great, and the use of Ant and Deck in the particular illusion and getting them both involved in the way that they were, all of that just made total, complete, and utter sense. And like I say, if you are lucky enough to get a TV spot, or you've worked hard enough to get a TV spot, and you've never done one before, well, my first advice is to go and speak to a consultant who's been there and done that, somebody like Russ Stevens, because there's going to be a million factors that you're not going to be aware of that they're going to be able to help you with. But the other thing is, watch this again, because this is a perfect example of how you take that TV spot and you really use it to your advantage and make the host look great, make the people involved with you and the illusion look great, but also make yourself look great as well. And there's no surprise that Russ became as big as he did on the circuit. And I think one of the reasons for that is because of his ability to be able to stage something and make it look as good as it possibly could. Now we're going to look at something completely different. We're going to have a look at a routine from many, many years ago that he did on Pebble Mill back in the day. Don't know if you remember Pebble Mill. I do. And this doesn't have a name. I'm going to call it Disembodied, and you'll see why in a bit. But this is another TV spot that he's got. So this is a TV show that used to be on years ago when I was a kid. And he's performing an illusion on this, okay? So this isn't like his own TV show or anything. He's performing on a TV spot on a show. Bear that in mind. I want you to watch this right now.
Let's have a little more prestidigitation. That's magic to you and me. From the man who's recently returned from a 3-month tour in South America with his show Illusion USA, Russ Stevens.
No, I...
Okay, so first of all, the first thing you need to understand is I have no idea how that trick works. That's an amazing trick. Like I've been doing illusions for years and I have no idea how that's done. It's fantastic. It's really good. And, you know, again, it's an example of a TV spot where he's wanting to come in and really kind of make an impact very, very quickly. And that's what you do with this. You know, anybody who watches illusionists, they know that, especially back when this went on in the 90s, there were certain preconceived ideas. The girl's going to get in the box. You're going to make the girl disappear or saw in half and then you're going to bring her back. This is the sort of stuff that people did all the time. And then you look at this illusion and it completely turns everything on its head. So first of all, the magician gets in the box, which is something that's not really seen. But these days, it's still not seen much these days, but wasn't seen, you know, almost at all back in the day there. So you've got the magician, the illusionist getting in the box. It's happening to them. And then the other thing is you've got not a complete vanish, but you've got the body vanishing. And it looks so good. And also look at the people that are actually doing this on Russ. I can tell he staged this exact thing because you've got the moment where the doors open and the hands are coming through, but you can't see all the way through. And then they're teasing that moment. And then the back door drops down and they can see all the way through. And then you're kind of there going, what did I just see? How is that even possible? And before you know it, it's over and the thing's done. But talk about creating an impact in 3 or 4 minutes. Like sometimes when you do these TV spots, you've only got 3 or 4 minutes in order to actually get the point across and to be able to actually, you know, kind of do what you're doing. And this is just really high impact. It really is. It's different. It's unique. It looks incredible. And again, it's exactly what a TV company would want, whilst at the same time furthering Russ's brand and showcasing his ability to perform on stage. Now, there's a reason why I wanted to show you this. And the reason is I found another video of Russ performing on stage. So this is not a TV thing. It's Russ performing on stage. And he's doing a routine that's called the Disembodied Spike Illusion. I'm not going to say anything until you've watched it. Watch this.
Imagine being locked and shackled inside this box with exactly 60 seconds to escape before this. Okay, I need a volunteer. I'm only kidding. These two spikes are operated by this timer. When the button's pushed, I've got exactly 60 seconds. That's 60 seconds to escape from the locks, the shackles, these chains, and this box before this happens to me. Thank you.
So that is the disembodied spike illusion. Now, I've never seen the disembodied that I showed you in the previous video, or this disembodied spike illusion, never seen it before. I sure as heck would like to own one. Never seen one before, but what's really interesting is that this disembodied spike illusion was basically the same trick, or very, very similar to the same illusion that took place on Pebble Mill, but the difference is it was framed as an escape. So rather than being presented the same way that he presented it on TV, it was framed as an escape. And I think that that's really important thing for anyone to understand. Not just illusionists, not just stage magicians, but close-up magicians as well. And this is something that I've tried to drive home on my channel over and over again, which is if you've got a prop, if you've got a particular thing, there's a multi-million different ways that you can actually use that. And yes, absolutely. One way to use it is to do it as you saw it on Pebble Mill and just have the vanish of the body. But you're seeing here that by changing it into an escape, you're completely changing everything about the routine. You're changing the way it comes across to the audience. You're changing the moments, the tension. And there's no right or wrong way of doing it. But it's very interesting that, you know, you can take basically the same prop and change it around slightly and have it play in a completely different way. You know, a lot of illusionists, they want to change their show around every season and buy all brand new illusions, which can be very, very expensive. Whilst if you can figure out a way to actually present it differently so it comes across as a different illusion, well then what you have is you have what you have here, which is, you know, the whole thing looks completely different. Also, I want you to understand again the music, you know, the music, the Jurassic Park music that Russ played in the background as it was happening, it just fit perfectly. And again, I'm not going to mention this on every video because I think that I've driven the point home enough now that musicality is so important. And if you plan on performing on stage, you have to think about music, not just the music that plays when you're actually performing an illusion or you're performing a card manipulation routine, but if you're doing a patter based act, what music is playing in the background, because music elevates an act to the nth degree. And you can see that here perfectly.
Thank you.
Now, the final performance video that you just saw is called, excuse me, The Slicer Illusion. And I remember, and I hope I'm not misremembering this, I don't think I am. I remember speaking to Russ a couple of years ago, and I remember him telling me that The Slicer Illusion is his favourite illusion of all time. And I can understand why. I mean, talk about a massive, huge prop that would play to the biggest audience. But I love the fact that there's so many beats. You know, I don't know how many people here do illusions, but a lot of people, a lot of close-up magicians especially that have never done it before, they think that all an illusionist does is point to a box, spin it round, girl gets out and that's it. Whilst in reality, learning how to be an illusionist was one of the hardest things that I ever did. It took years of practice to even get to a level where I was, which is nowhere near the level that Russ Stevens was. But there's so many things that you need to think of. There's so many moments that, the whole thing, if you don't carry yourself correctly, if you don't walk correctly, then it's just going to die on its arse. It needs practice and practice and practice again. And when you think you've got it perfect, you're going to practice it again and you're going to rehearse it again. You're going to get a director to come in and watch you do it. There's so many things. It's not just pointing at a box, spinning a box and getting the girl out. There's so much more to it than that. And you see The Slicer Illusion, go and watch that performance again. This is a perfect example of that. You know, every moment has a purpose. Every moment is designed to build tension. Every moment is designed to showcase this in the best way that it can be. And, you know, I'm going to go so far as saying that The Slicer Illusion that you just saw the video of right there is an absolute work of art and an example of why Russ Stevens was one of the best illusionists of all time and why he has inspired so many magicians over the years and why he is absolutely the best choice to be working on a show like Britain's Got Talent, where he can take this experience and he can take this ability and use it to help other people come up to his level as well. And I have first-class experience of that, having worked with him with Ryland. So there you go, guys. That's another 5x5 in the bag. This one, as I say, was a really important one for me to do because I've got so much respect for Russ Stevens. I really have. Now it's over to you. I want you to tell me what you think. Have you seen Russ perform? Are you old enough to remember Russ in the Mystique show? If you are, let me know in the comments down below and tell me your favourite memory. Do you want to see more Performance 555 specials? Is there a particular person you'd like me to do it on? Please let me know in the comments down below. Don't forget, you want to see more videos like this? Like the video, subscribe to the channel, leave a comment down below. Don't forget you can join The Netrix by going to www.thenetrix.com. That's www.thenetrix.com. Go see what all the fuss is about. But I'll see you again soon. Thank you so much for watching. My name's Craig from Magic TV.